Hello again, everybody, and welcome back to Fujit's Blitz with me, Fujit. Hello. So a lot of people have been asking me what is decent in the auction at the moment, and to be fair, it's a mixed bag. Coming in at number one, we have the T-25 Pilot. Now, this is actually starting to go for a bargain. Yeah, okay, it's not the best tank in the game, but you know what? It's not that bad either. Even Martin Dogger, who I was speaking to only yesterday, is starting to believe there's a bargain to be had there. And not everybody hates the T-25 Pilot. I don't particularly hate it. And Every Good Name Is Taken also doesn't particularly hate it. And at 4,500 gold, with 4,000 being the next price drop in about 7.5 hours, it is actually starting to look like a pretty nice bargain. Next, we have the TS-5. Now, I'm not a big fan of this tank, mainly because it's got terrible gun mobility, if I'm being honest. I mean, it's got next to no gun depression, and the mobility left and right is pretty bad also. It also hasn't got the best armor profile. But you know what? I mean, this tank came in crates, and I didn't buy it then. And at the moment, it's at 9,100, and I'm tempted not to buy it now. Now, there's still 4,466 of these damn things out there. I don't have this one in my garage, so I am looking to get it, but not at the price that it's currently at. I'm going to wait for it to drop. And I'm hoping I can get this for around 7,000, but we'll see. Next up, we have the Kanone and Jagdpanzer 105. A nice little TD, funnily enough. I do like this tank, and when it first came out, it was a bit pricey back then. But it's a pretty funky little TD. It's 8,500, it's still a little bit pricey, and I would wait till it gets down for that next price drop, or maybe the one after that. Next up, we have the Camp 70, a nice little tier 9. I mean, this tank's done the rounds now, and it's starting to look pretty decent price-wise. The next price drop is at 8,500. Maybe you want to wait for the second price drop when it gets down to 8,000. That is not a bad price at all, if I'm being honest. Because it is a pretty decent tier 9. Next, we have the Lycan. Now, this one is selling out rapidly. It's a pretty rare tank, and it's pretty decent. At the moment, there's only 3,700 of these things left, and it's currently at 8,600. You may want to wait, because, you know, there's a couple of more hours, and it will drop down to 7,900. If you wait much longer than that, the chances are it's going to go, and it is a pretty decent tank. Then you got to ask yourself, if you're not a tank collector, are you going to be playing it that often? Next, we have the plucky little German Bulldog. There are 3,670 of these left, and it's going for 5,500 currently. Next price drop will be coming out at 5,000, which is a bargain for this tank. It's a beautiful little tank, especially if you like your light tanks. And 5,000 gold isn't bad for this little beastie. We then move on to a tier 8 TD, the T-28 Defender, currently going for 6,500. Now, when this tank first came out, it was a fantastic tank, and a lot of people didn't know how to counter it. Since then, it's been power crept a little bit. 6,500, not a bad price, but it may be better to wait that a little bit longer and get it for that bargain price of 6,000 instead. Because it's still a pretty formidable tier 8 TD. Next on the list, we have the Object 252U, quite a formidable tier 8 heavy tank, and a main staple of, especially those on the Agent server. At the moment, it's going for 7,500. There's just over 3,300 of these left. Next price drop, 7,000. To be honest with you, that's a bit of a bargain for this tank. And it's still current meta, it's still a good tank. Okay, there are better tanks in tier 8 nowadays, but you know what? This one is still a bit of a formidable beastie. So wait for that price to come down just a little bit. Once it hits that 7,000, then that is a bargain basement price. And if you don't have it in your garage, you can't really go wrong. Next, we have a tier 10, the M60. Now, these are running out fast. And at the moment, that price of 13,000 is pretty sweet, to be fair. Don't forget, it is a tier 10. Tier 10s normally go for 20,000 gold. So you're going to get a decent tank here. In 7 hours, it will drop down to 12,000, which you really need to bite Wargaming's hands off once it gets to that price. You would be crazy not to. The M60, while a lot of people give it a bad reputation, it has been buffed recently, and it does play exactly like the pattern. So if you need that tier 10, that is one you should be looking at getting. Unfortunately, the Chieftain Mark 6 is already out of the auction. So this is the only tier 10 in this round that you can get your paws on. Following on from the M60, we drop back down into tier 8, and this time the Defender Mark 1, which is a truly fantastic tank. This one is going for 7,500. I'm telling you guys, there's only 1,300 of these left, and that is a really stonkingly good price. I think it is. This is a formidably fantastic tank. It's got great armor, great gun. It has got a 4-clip magazine. It is an autoloader. In the right hands, this thing is a pain in the backside and a menace. I mean, that turret is rock solid. And you know what? 7,500, you should be biting their hands off. Finally, for this round, we have the Howthing. Now, it's going for 10,000 at the moment. I think that is overpriced. There's a lot of people out there who want the Howthing because it's been overhyped. It's not the tank it used to be. In the right hands, it's still a fantastic tank, but it is not the tank it used to be. There are a lot of better tanks in that tier nowadays that will give it a hard time. Think of along the lines of the Smasher and the Annihilator. Thing is, I mean, if you haven't got it and you're a tank collector, then obviously it's going to be tempting. There's only 1,100 of these left, but 10,000 in my book, well, I just think that's a little bit too pricey for what it is. I've got the Howthing, I very rarely play it, so be mindful of that, guys. 10,000 gold, a bit too much, I think, at this stage. But at the end of the day, it's not for me to tell you how to spend your hard-earned gold. This round will finish on the 24th. So there's only 4 more days left before this round of the auction will finish and round 2 will begin. You can see that the tanks are already covered up saying available soon. Once those hit on the 24th, I will let you know and we'll go through those again. Those are my picks. I mean, you may agree with me, you may disagree with me. It's up to you. At the end of the day, it's your gold. It's not my gold. It's your cash. It's not my cash. But taking the tanks as a whole and looking at what they have. Now, to me, I've got every single one of these tanks apart from the TS5 in my garage already. And I'm telling you from my perspective what I think of bargains or not. It's an opinion. That's all it is. You may not share my opinion anyway. That has been my take on this round of the auction. Finishes in a fair few days, so comment and everything below. And remember, guys, don't just go out there and spend all your hard-earned cash immediately. Be mindful about what tanks you are going to play, especially if you're not a tank collector. And until the next time, happy Christmas to everybody. Stay safe out there. Have fun on the battlefield. And happy tanking, because that is what it's all about. Having fun and being happy.